In this video, you guys are going to see 8 denim jackets, and literally you guys are covered with each and every color of the denim jacket you should go for, starting with the dark blue color to the different washes of the blue color, black color and pop colors as well. So this is one of the best denim jacket haul videos for 2020 and also for 2021. What's up my stylish people, this is Shashank, welcome back to the channel. In this channel, I do outfit inspirations, shopping and styling tips along with shopping hauls just like this. If you're new here, consider subscribing. If you don't know by this time, denim jacket should be a must-have piece in your wardrobe, and I always suggest you guys not to cheap out on the denim jacket, because this is not just the piece which you will use this season and throw it away and you will purchase one more piece the next season. You should buy a denim jacket which you should be using at least for next 3 to 4 years, because the fit as well as the structure and how they look, it's not going to change much. As always, let's find out in this denim jacket haul the differences between the cheap versus expensive denim jackets. I will go from higher price point to lower price point in this video so that you will get a better idea of that, what exactly the differences you are going to see from the higher to lower price points. A common point for all the denim jackets you are going to see in this video: they come with a collar, and also they come with a double chest pockets and 2 slit pockets. And starting with the piece number 1, I got this dark blue solid colored denim jacket from LP Jeans in a size of medium. It is priced at $4,499. To start with the composition, it is made of 98% cotton and 2% elastane to it. It is having that slight stretch to it, which is always good when it comes to the denim jackets. It do not have any washed aspect to it. It is having that dark blue raw denim kind of a feel, even though it's made of cotton. On top of that, I like the attention to detail with the light orange color stitchings. I exactly have the same combination of this dark blue raw denim kind of a feel with the orange stitchings jeans from Jack & Jones. So I wanted to use this as a coordinate set for winters. This would be an awesome combination because you are going to look classic when it comes to the dark blue color, and also it's not going to be too boring because they have differentiated by using this orange stitchings to it. It fits right to me, but it is having a little bit of a boxy kind of a fit to it. What I did not like is this sleeve length. One, the sleeves are too long for its size because I have gone for medium size. And anyway, I'm not going to just button the sleeves when it comes to denim jackets. I'm always going to pin roll it. Once I start pin rolling it, it exposes the material of the inner side of the jacket. That color contrast gives a good appeal. If you want to pin roll only 1/4 of the sleeves, it's not going to look presentable because it is not as thick as the material when compared to the normal standard denim jacket. You have to pin roll it at least till half of the sleeves so that it will look presentable. Yes, this is a disqualifier which is minor, but still I wanted to point out that it retails at 4,500 rupees, but I got this at a price point of 2,100, I think so. Moving on to the next price point, which is at 3,500 rupees. It is a olive green denim trucker jacket from Jack & Jones, which I got it in a size of small. As I mentioned, it is priced at 3,500 rupees. Jack & Jones is one of my favorite brand when it comes to denim jackets. Even though they are made of 100% cotton and they do not have any stretch to it, the quality they offer at the price point of 3,500, if you are following this channel from quite some time, I like olive, burgundy as well as mustard when it comes to the colors other than the neutral. So I liked in terms of the color, and when it comes to the practical utility of using the denim jacket during the winter season, the material, the denim, it is little bit on the rougher side. When you touch it, jacket feels of a high quality one. The fit of the jacket is a slim fit one, sized down in order to get a proper fit when it comes to the Jack & Jones jackets. Previously, I used to go for medium size. Medium size, it's a little bit on the regular side, if I have to say. As I always mention for the denim jackets, the t-shirt or a base layer which you are using need to be on the lengthier side when compared to the jacket length. So it's a better practice to size it down in case if your sleeve length is perfect and overall chest size fits perfect. At a price point of 3,500, if I have to recommend a denim jacket which can last you really, really long, this should be the denim trucker jacket I would suggest. Moving on to the next price point, 3,000 rupees. Here I have 4 options, guys, both from Zara as well as H&M. Starting with the denim trucker jacket number 3. It is a red color denim trucker jacket from Zara, which I got it in a size of medium. If you own blue, black color denim jacket, if you already have them with you, these are the color options you should target for. you should go for different color options. You should go for at least one pop color. I already have almost all of the colors. That's the reason I have gone with this red color. This is one of my favorite pieces from the shopping haul, guys, because of the color. It's not in your face kind of a red color, rather it is in the lines of a brick red color. So I like the color of it, and the contrast of the denim trucker jacket with the silver buttons they have gone for, it looks so good. I don't think we need a special mention on the quality of these Zara denim jackets, but if I have to mention, the quality is really great. It is also a stretch denim jacket, even though in the composition of the materials on the Zara site it's mentioned as 100% cotton, they have mentioned this as the stretch denim jackets. So you're going to get the comfort as well as the style, and they have this in different color options, not necessarily that you have to go with this red color. Coming to the fit of it, it is a slim fit jacket. I have gone true to size, so don't size down when it comes to Zara denim jackets. I think it fits the best of all in terms of the sleeve length, in terms of where exactly the overall length it ends. Right now there is no discount at all. Probably there will be a Zara sale coming up in December, maybe during the Christmas week. If you find this at anywhere at 50% off, make sure that you go for these color combinations if you don't have one. Moving on to the piece number 4. It is a white color stretch denim trucker jacket from Zara, which I got it in a size of medium. It is the same jacket which I got it in a white color, because I do not have any jacket, denim jacket, in white color. So I thought, let's give it a try. But a spoiler alert, white color is not going to be super versatile when it comes to denim jackets. This should be almost the last option you should go when it comes to the neutral colors. Whatever the advantages I mentioned with the brick red colored denim trucker jacket from Zara stays the same for this one as well. And also a noteworthy point to consider, both the white color as well as the brick red colored jacket from Zara, they are slightly faded, even though you may not see it instantly, but if you observe them closely, they have this slightly faded aspect to it. If you're not tight on budget, and if you're a big fan of Zara like I am, I think you should consider this option, not only these colors but denim jackets from Zara in general. In 3000 rupees price point, moving on to the piece number 5 and 6, both are from H&M, and both of them are the blue color washed sustainable denim jacket from H&M. Both are almost similar. Then why I got two of them? In order to show to you guys, because when you go to the H&M website, they have almost like 4 denim jackets. In that, almost 2 of them look exactly similar. When you're going for that, you should really know what exactly are the differences to it. So both of them are washed. But however, one of the jacket which you have seen in my Myntra jackets haul, that jacket is a little bit on the darker side when it comes to wash. And the jacket which I got for this video, which is the light wash among the light wash, which is actually weird to say. But if you have a glance at both of them, you may not see any differences at all, guys. Coming to the fit of it, I have sized it down. I have gone with the size small. The sleeve length, it's a little bit short. And as I mentioned earlier, anyway, I'm going to pin roll the sleeves, so it's not a big deal for me. And overall, the length is a little bit short, but it works for the denim jacket. The quality, it's a sustainable denim jacket, so it comes with 100% cotton to it, but it is having that rough texture. But I think it works when it comes to the winter seasons. Overall, at a price point of 3000 rupees, if I have to pick one among H&M and Zara, I think I would be going for Zara options, even though I like the environmental friendly aspect when it comes to the sustainability. But I think overall, when it comes to the fit and the comfort, because the Zara options, they have the stretch to it. These options from H&M, even though as good as they are when it comes to the looks and the washed aspect, I feel if you have to consider both the comfort and fit of it, I think at 3000 rupees price point, you would be better off going with the Zara jackets. Now let's get into the price point of 2390, which is the last price point for this video. For this price point and the piece number 7 and 8, it is from a brand called Highlander. I got you guys covered with two options. Let's talk about the piece number 7 first. It is a black color denim trucker jacket from Highlander, which is from their vintage collection series. It is also having a slight washed aspect to it. I got this in a size of medium. This is one of the best jacket which you can get at a price point of 700 to 800 rupees, guys. Trust me, it can't be better than this, both in terms of the quality as well as the fit of it. Even though the sleeves are a little bit lengthier to my liking, but the material is thicker. It provides you enough warmth during the winter seasons. If you're tight on budget, I would recommend this. Moving on to the piece number 8, it is a beige colored Highlander denim trucker jacket, which I got it in a size of medium. And the fit of it, it's a little bit on the boxy side. It's not exactly the same fit of the black color denim jacket. The material is very thin when compared to the black color denim jacket from Highlander, but that's not always a bad thing. If you are going for a light layering, this should be your go-to option rather than the black color one, because the material is on the thicker side for the black one. Even though it's mentioned as a beige color, it looks to me more on the olive brown side. At a price point of 700, I do not have many complaints except for one minor disqualifier is the length of the sleeves. How much you should spend on a denim jacket? As I mentioned, the core point stays the same. If you have budget, please do not cheap out on the denim jackets, because you are not going to replace them every single year. Few of the denim jackets I have, I almost used them from last 2 to 3 years and still stays the same because I have gone with the better options. Or if you have a budget of 1500 at least, make sure that you buy Zara, H&M or Jack & Jones on discount when they're at a price point of that 1500. However, if you are super tight on budget, there is no other option for you rather than spending below 1000 rupees. You will be better served off going with the vintage version of the Highlander denim trucker jackets, because you're almost getting the similar feel and fit of it. Maybe longevity you will not get, but except for that, you will get every aspect of the Zara denim jacket at a price point of 700 to 800 rupees. As per my experience, these are the brands which I felt would be a great choice for this denim jacket haul. I hope you guys like this video. If you did so, don't forget to click the like button, and also don't forget to subscribe to the channel not to miss out on any content like this in the future. That's it from me. See you guys next time.